Todd Versteeg with the Equipment Voice, and I'm at the JCB booth, and I've had a chance to catch up with Karen. Karen, what do you do with JCB?
I'm the marketing director for North America.
Great. And so, I mean, the rental show, why do you guys come to this show?
This is a good channel for us. All of the market data that we've been seeing and receiving from the American Rental Association show growth. So it's been 2 years in a row of pretty impressive growth with that projected out into 2016. I think a lot of the trends that we see in the industry, especially in uncertain economic times, have led to a bit of a shift between the sales of construction equipment and people making the choice to rent until some of that economic certainty comes. So we feel like it's a very viable channel for us.
Okay. Well, you know, I know that there's a lot of people in the industry that are looking at social media and trying to figure out how to incorporate it. And quite honestly, from the outside, JCB tends to be a model for a lot of manufacturers in the industry when it comes to social media. So, you know, if you could kind of tell me about your guys' program, what made you decide to kind of journey down that social media path and kind of some of the results you guys have seen, you know, over the last few years with some of your social efforts?
Sure. Well, first of all, thank you for saying that. We definitely felt like we were one of the early adopters. And it was pretty simple. It was a space that we had been watching and kind of listening to as the popularity of blogs and some of the other digital media started to grow in popularity. It was one of those things that, you know, we felt and I felt pretty strongly personally that conversations were happening. And they were happening in the digital space with our customers and our potential customers. So we could actively participate in those conversations and help shape thought or be a thought leader in that space, or we could let it happen without us knowing. And so we chose to get involved. And when we first set out, we didn't know what that would look like. We did a lot of research, a lot of listening, a lot of monitoring, finding out where the customers were most active, what forums were already existing, where they were comfortable sharing their stories, and came up with a model that we felt was right for us at JCB and for our family of distributors as well. So we launched a blog called The Dirt. We basically used a hub and spoke model, for lack of a better description. And so the blog served as our hub, and off of that we ran all the traditional Facebook channels. So we had a Twitter account, a Facebook account. We established a YouTube channel for customers to share and post their application videos and anything unique that they had to tell about the brand. I don't think our journey is different than many other companies that get active in the social space. So when we started, it was a lot of one-way communication or limited communication. So it was populating information, delivering content, making sure we had interesting and unique stories that were applicable to the social space. And now, you know, about 4 years down the road from initially launching, it's fun to watch.
Yeah.
We're more of a spectator on our social sites, and we basically think of ourselves as the hosts of the party. And so we invite anyone who's a fan of a brand or someone who's active in the industry, even people that may have something useful or constructive to say about a product or the way that we deliver service. And we just like to be a part of those conversations and take place.
Okay. You know, one of the things you said that I thought was really interesting is that you guys started out like everybody else, really kind of trying to decide what kind of relevant information you push. I think the challenge becomes is that everybody gets really excited about getting that social space.
Sure.
And then they, you know, they have all kinds of ideas about what they're going to post, and then they're not seeing people sort of latch on, and they don't see that big growth happen right out of the gate on the whole
Sure.
thing. That becomes a point of frustration. How do you push past that? How do you kind of get to that next level where you do sort of get to a point where it doesn't feel like it's you guys just kind of putting out noise, but in turn kind of developing your own community?
Sure. I think it's a journey. So you have to earn the trust of the people that are visiting and choosing to converse on your site. One of the things that JCB did very early on is we did a charity project. It was Backhoe Across America.
Uh-huh.
So
I remember that.
Just after the earthquake in Haiti, We sent equipment in, and we felt like we needed to do more, and so we wanted to figure out a way to engage our North American dealer partners in this charitable giving and this phenomenal outreach that was happening all over the country already.
Yeah.
So we drove a backhoe from Savannah, Georgia, all the way to Santa Monica, California, and it was just one of those kind of true grassroots fundraising at its best. And it was, we weren't pushing a corporate message, we weren't trying to sell product, we were very altruistically trying to embrace the larger JCB family and involve them in something that was bigger than us and bigger than the industry. And I think that helped us gain a following, and it also got us some of that loyalty and built that level of trust.
Okay. You know, another thing I wanted to mention too is that from a monitoring standpoint, as you start to kind of sort of hear people talk about JCB, what sort of process or product do you guys use to sort of listen out there to the social media channels?
We've kind of evolved through a couple of different products, and I think, you know, as a brand, if you're looking to set up social media channels or a platform, it's one of those things that you need to be okay with as an organization and understand that part of what makes social media so great is the same thing that makes it very scary.
Yeah.
For some of the senior level executives that are used to that one-way communication. So you have to be okay with giving up a portion of that control. And I would definitely recommend before anyone engage in social media, gauge what your comfort level with that is, and just be very transparent about it with your users. So if you choose to moderate, and you choose to moderate at a level where you're censoring the type of information that's shared,
yeah.
Be transparent about it.
Okay.
And so, you know, we've done that on all of our social sites. We have a social media policy. And it's pretty basic. We welcome all feedback.
Yeah.
When it starts to be, you know, it's harmful or, you know, language is something that, you know, we're pretty sensitive to. But just helpful, like be helpful and add value. So if you're, you know, a naysayer or you're attacking other community members, then we will intervene and take conversations offline if need be. But we're very upfront with what we do and what we moderate. And if we, you know, there's only been one or two instances where we've taken content down.
Okay.
But we're very transparent about it.
Appreciate your time, and you know, we'll keep watching and paying attention to what you guys are doing. So thanks a lot.
Absolutely. Well,